Today we're taking a look at how I've implemented the trigonometry for my raycasting engine in Factorio. Just to clarify, this is how I did it. I'm not claiming this is a particularly good way to do it. In fact, there's a lot of room for improvement here. For calculating rotations, we need two trigonometry functions, sine and cosine. However, sine is free if you have implemented cosine, as sine is also equal to the cosine of pi over 2 minus x. Or to get a more efficient implementation in Factorio, cosine of x plus 3 pi over 2. Just to clarify for people who are only used to working with degrees, 2 pi radians is the same as 360 degrees. For cosine, we only need to find half the function, as we can do cosine of pi plus x equals negative cosine of x for the other half. For the half we do have to implement, it started with some research. This led me to the Wikipedia page of Pashkara sine approximation. There are many forms of the formula there, but we're interested in this one. We have to modify it a bit before we can use it in Factorio though. First of all, you'll have trouble entering the input angle, as Factorio only accepts whole numbers. So for example, you can't enter half a radian. We want to be able to use an input x that goes from 0 to some constant a instead, where x equaling a means a full rotation. So x equals a times y divided by 2 pi, or inversed, y equals 2 pi times x divided by a. We can fill this in the original equation. Bring the squaring inside the brackets. Pi's cancel each other out. Get rid of the divide by a squared. Some more rearranging. The output has the same problem the input had. Factorio can only represent whole numbers. The function would be pointless if it could only output 0, 1 or negative 1 and nothing in between. So instead of calculating cosine directly, we calculate cosine times some constant b instead. Now we create a new problem though. Factorio can't represent values larger than 2,147,483,647, and we risk going over that number in our calculations. So we divide both the numerator and the denominator by a constant c. The bigger c, the more rounding errors occur. For version 1 of Factorio, I use the following values. A equals 1200, b equals 1000, c equals 4. When implemented in Factorio, you get this. But how good is this at calculating cosine? Let's plot the error. First, the cosine itself has a reference for size. And here is the error of the implementation compared to the real cosine. The error goes up and down so fast that it wouldn't be very helpful to plot it outright at the scale. Instead, I've colored the area that the error function goes through. It's probably clearer if I just show it. Here I'm drawing the full error function. It goes up and down constantly. So I've colored between the higher and lower points of the error function. We have to pay attention to two things on this error function: accuracy and precision. You might think those are the same, but they are not. To quote Wikipedia, accuracy is closeness of measurements to a specific value, while precision is the closeness of the measurements to each other. So to improve accuracy, we need to get closer to zero. To improve the precision, we need to decrease the size of the colored region and keep it from going up and down like crazy. Why do we even care about precision if the accuracy is good? Because low precision makes small errors more noticeable. If an error in our calculations causes something to be rendered slightly too big, that will be more noticeable if everything around it is rendered slightly too small. For version 2, I needed a lot higher input and output resolution. A and B became 65,536. C is now also 65,536 to compensate. The resulting blueprint looks equivalent, but the values used inside the combinators are slightly different. The only visual difference are these combinators at the bottom, but they only add a delay, as version 2 is more sensitive to timing problems. The new error is in blue, the old one is in red. This is a significant improvement, both in accuracy and precision. However, If we zoom in, we can see some weirdness. There is clearly room for improvement here in terms of precision. These artifacts are caused by setting C too high. Just to reiterate, the value C is chosen to make sure the numerator isn't larger than 2,147,483,647, the largest value you can represent in Factorio. There are other ways to keep the numerator small though. For example, if we want to divide some number E by another number F, we can do this division with a smaller numerator if we have an estimate for the result G. E minus F times G is a lot smaller than E. We can apply the same principle to our previous formula. We get this, where D represents our estimate. Now, how do we get this estimate? We can simply use the result from before, the one that wasn't accurate enough. Due to these improvements, we can decrease C to 8. The resulting error is plotted in red with the previous one in blue. The accuracy is about the same as before, but the precision has been improved. But we can do a lot better though. But decreasing the rounding errors won't do, as the error that's left isn't the result of rounding errors, or at least it's not the biggest cause. It's mostly that our starting formula didn't calculate cosine, it just approximated it. First of all, the error function repeats. So we only need to look at 1/4 of this graph. Next we divide this up into 256 equally sized sections. For each section we find the linear function that best approximates it. This way when we calculate cosine, we just need to figure out which section we need, find the value of our linear function and subtract it from our result. This cancels out most of the error. Now if we take a look at these linear functions, you may notice something strange. These linear functions aren't actually linear. This is because we have the same input and output limitations as our original calculation. We're calculating 65,536 times cosine, so we can only express values in multiples of 1 over 65,536. Now, how do we calculate the linear functions we need? Normally, you just use the least squares method. But because our linear functions aren't completely linear, that's not enough. It's still close to the optimum though. So I decided to just wiggle the resulting functions from the least squares method and test each time how good the result is. And I just kept the best one. Now we have the linear functions we want. But how do we store them in Factorio? Linear functions can be described as the slope times x plus offset. So we only need to store the slope and the offset. Luckily, because the error is small, we can bitpack these together. Then we can store these in a compact XOR lookup table. I made a video about those before. If you want to know how they work, links are everywhere. If we put everything discussed in this video together, we get this. It's still surprisingly compact. If we plot the new error, it's also very good. The new error is in blue, the old one is in red. Look at how far we have to zoom in. Let's compare it to the error function from version 1. The difference is enormous. I hope my explanation was clear. Thanks for watching.